Greetings, everyone. My name is Sharon, and I wanted to make this video for Twin Flames or the collective, doesn't matter, you know, not without any labels. I am a twin flame. I live in New York. I wanted to make this video. I've been guided to do this video so that way you can have a greater understanding of who I am, what I'm here for each and every one of you, including myself. And this is about coming to a place of healing and understanding yourselves, not leaving anything out. I always talk about the fact that whenever something comes up missing, it often leads to pain and confusion and chaos. The reason that I have been guided to do this video is to help those who are at this part in their journey where you're getting closer to your union and how important it is to stay within your power, stay within your own power, whether you're a masculine or feminine. So I choose not to separate it in this moment. If I do speak of anything in separation, it's just for you to have an understanding of what it means. One of the reasons why I am here on the planet, not just to say that I'm a twin flame or as being a twin flame, is to help those, so as I see 333 on the clock, all is well. And the Ascended Masters are here. And this is for each and every one of you to have a, I would say, more details, okay? So I'm very detailed. I'm very detailed in terms of how I explain things. And when we allow ourselves to understand things with an explanation behind it, then what happens? You have more clarity, where it's not just on the surface. Things are not just on the surface. So the soul in and of itself is free, truly free. And the soul does not care about gender, color of your skin, culture, background, any of these things. The reason, the purpose behind for us to incarnate, coming from different countries and cultures, your personalities, everything plays a part and a role to who you are. We caused ourselves to forget who we are so we can remember who we are. Do you understand? In other words, everything there is to know about yourself is in the knowing, okay? And for example, you read a book, you have an understanding about this book based on what you know. But then it becomes clearer and there's more that you get to understand about yourself in the physical body based on the experiences you have from what you know. And so if you already are in this realm of absolute, the realm of absolute is what exists on the other side, where everything is in its purity, everything is in its true form as love. Just love, that's it. Nothing less than that, just pure love. Now I know some people, they ask and they say, well, what happens after you die? You don't die. You don't, you say, but yes, I if I'm out of the shell of this body, I'm dead. I'm gone. I'm no longer here. That's not true. You have always existed and you continue to exist. A part of you is eternal, everlasting, from the beginning until the end and now. So when you hear me speaking, I'm going to speak in terms of for those who may not even understand or even know that they're reincarnated. Because, you know, I love when I interact with others and I don't discriminate or judge anyone with anything. I don't. Because, you see, I'm at a level of understanding and knowing that we all see things in different eyes. We're all in different perspectives. Okay, so when I speak to anyone, I come across with wisdom. I tune in first to where I feel they may be based on what they may say or may not say. And the thing about this was different with me is that I come with it with patience and compassion and love. So we caused ourselves to forget so we can remember who we are. And in that memory, as far as remembering who you are, is when we are aligning our soul to our physical bodies, the physical plane in all these dimensions, okay? There are so much things for us to understand. There's so much for us to know about ourselves. And I can put it to you this way. Everything and all the things for you to understand lies within you. This is not a learning session. This is not a school. People, I know some say, oh, we're here to learn. We're here to learn our lessons. We're here to remember. There's a difference with that. It's almost like having a little amnesia, but not quite. It's almost like going to sleep a little bit, and then you took a bit off of something. You know, you have the children's stories that talk about the biting of an apple, and then you have the biblical story of the biting of an apple, and you're in, and what happens in the children's stories, I believe it was Sleeping Beauty, she fell asleep, right? And so Adam and Eve, as the story was written, is that, which is a metaphorical story, but there was truly a beginning of time as the masculine and feminine. You know, because we are the essence and we are the particles of God that came from the original Adam. There are some who don't even realize that and to understand. Well, guess what? The time is coming where we're coming back to understanding ourselves and to know the true meaning of why we are here. Why we're all here. Why we're all gathered here together. And from this Adam that split into many, there are some who started out androgynous, as one would say, meaning that together, joined together. You know, that's why that saying goes, whatsoever God has joined together, let no man put asunder. And that is the sacred marriage. That's not the human man marriage where you take your vows and all these things. And I'm not saying anything against marriages. I'm just explaining to you so you can understand. So I want you to know that I'm here to help for each soul that comes into contact with me, whether directly or indirectly, to understand what is a twin flame. Because, you know, I even asked someone, I said, do you know what a twin flame is? No, never heard that. I said, do you know what sacred geometry? Nope, I don't know what that is. Do you know about what divine masculine and feminine is? They don't know. Do you know that you've been here many times before? Really? Yeah, really. How many times? Hundreds of thousands of times. This is not about right or wrong. This is about seeking to know the truth about where we started from and what roles we place in each other's lives. I'm not going to discuss the labeling of, you know, soulmates and all these things. I just wanted to do this as like an overview so you can see me, because one of the best things that human beings understand things more is by visual. The highest level of communication is interacting with one another in person. So even if we're not able to interact in person, then we're able to, you know, talk on the phone and interacting through, I would say, Skype or Tango or FaceTime, you know, or Snapchat or, you know, all these things. And then the next level, you know, after that would be instant messaging, okay? Because there's still some type of a live interaction taking place. And then the next level before that, after that, I should say, is typing, texting, emailing. That is practically barely any interaction, except you are interacting based on exchanging words. Words is the lowest form of communication. Words existed, of course, in time because there was languages that came into play. The languages were broken down, what they call it, the Tower of Babel. And that existed because that's when more of the separation took place throughout human history. It has nothing to do with being evil or the sin of mankind, because I want you to understand, sin in Aramaic means missing the mark. And so many have fallen short of the grace of not understanding, missing the mark, missing and dissing. So, like I said, I chose to talk about this physically where you're seeing me, because most of my segments, I'm doing an audiobook, and this audiobook is called The Return of the Garden of Eden. This audiobook is based on segments to do with all of ourselves throughout history, besides my twin flame journey, and I would say my full-blown awakening is what I call it. So I've been recording since December 31st, 2014, I would say, up until present. So there's days when I may record and days I may not, you know, depends on what's going on. So I'm really literally living multi-dimensionally, multitasking and everything. And no matter what has happened or what I'm facing, I'm still staying within my own joy. You're hearing music in the background, and the reason is because I like to have the energy uplifting while I'm speaking, because there's times when we are going to be speaking on things that might be not so great, and there's things that we might be speaking that might be sad, or and it's okay. It's okay to own up to your feelings of what you're experiencing, okay? As I said before, there is no right and wrong, it just is. And we all see things from different perspectives. We all see things from different ideas, thoughts, personalities, background, culture. And what happened is that my book is titled The Return of the Garden of Eden, because we're rewinding back to the past, bring ourselves to the present with what serves our highest good and what doesn't. It is time for each person who's ready, of course, to understand what is happening on the planet now, because there are a lot of changes happening. We're not in the, a lot of us are having things changing right before our eyes with a lot of things. You're either changing jobs, changing location, you're no longer with your spouses, you might be having issues with your children, at your job, you might be working less hours, have no job at all. Everything is being stripped away, and this has nothing to do with evil, as one would say, or terrorism. You know, there's a lot of things out there that are false representation and things to confuse others. But when you understand what you're experiencing, you allow yourself and your journey to become a lot easier, so there's less panic. One of the things that has happened in the human race is that when one does not understand what is going on or what's happening, they're labeled as witches and, you know, sorcery, or in, like in my country, I'm from Jamaica, you know, they say, oh, somebody put hobby upon you, or oh, some voodoo shit going on, you know, and the nature of the beast. And you say, what is the beast? You know, I spoke about it at the segments about the beast, the 666, and people get so afraid when they see the number. And you see, all these things were put into place. It's still put into place on purpose. And even if it was a, it was put in place for, to depict whatever is happening to do with the evil of people or whatever, or someone who's leading the world into destruction and all that stuff. Again, it's based on something that you read. You read it and you read something that's based on someone else's experience, but are you listening to your own experiences? Are you paying attention to it? Because you know what? Your experience is the strongest language. It is. You have your thoughts, then you have your belief systems and your knowing, right? And then it's based on perceptions, because sometimes it might be a perception of someone else. And when you take on a perception of someone else, you're giving away your power. And so it's for you to understand that your experience is what is showing you the way back to yourself. Because the way back to yourself, the way to God, is coming home. Your home is where the heart is. So what's changing on the planet is that the communication is not going to be coming from just your head. It's going to be coming and aligning from your heart to your head. And I'm going to give you an example. Friday, I went to a restaurant to get food for my children, and I was talking to this young man who was making jokes and everything. Of course, I can't help it. I just love to laugh. You know, laughing is good. When you laugh, you're purging out negative stuff. Really, you know, and it helps. So anybody who knows me well knows that when you're around me, you will get a belly laugh. I tell you, you know, make sure you get your Depends ready, because you're going to be laughing. And even when I'm going through my own stuff and I say, you know what, let me put on some comedy, or even make my own jokes, for, you know, whether, and with my kids, the same thing, we laugh and laugh, and it's good to do that. So it's either laughing, loving, something along those lines, dancing. Everybody knows me, I love to dance, and it elevates you. So I don't want to come off topic of what I say, because I don't want to forget anything. And when I was at the restaurant there talking, and of course I was in conversation with two different people, and he said to me, because the young man asked me, you know, what do I do? And I told him, I said, well, I said, I am a medium. And he said, you're a medium? He said, you mean like Long Island medium that's in New York here? And I was like, well, something like that. I said I'm a medium. I'm clairaudient, clairsentient, which means because there's people who don't even know what that is or understand what it means, and right away they start to think all kinds of thoughts. That means that I have other senses besides the five senses that comes with the physical body, which is seeing, touching, smelling, feeling, hearing. There are other senses that we have, and it depends on each person. If you choose to open yourself to that part of you and aligning and connecting to it, because we're all psychic, we're all have the ability to, some of us are more enhanced with that ability depending on who you are, what you're here for, and how much you want to attain with yourself and understanding all of this and how it connects to God. So when I was standing there talking now and saying this to the young man, he was getting fascinated. And so this man that was paying for his food, he looks at me and he said, because I was taking up his bag by accident. So he said to me, well, if you're a medium, how come you didn't know that it was my bag? So I said, really now? And he's like, oh, you're getting, he said, are you getting upset? And I said, no. I said, why would I? It's like, no. So he said, well, you know what? I don't know if I want to, you know, if I'm going to say anything about what I believe in, what, you know, you're saying, because, you know, I'm here. I'm more into what I'm thinking of God. So I said, let me ask you something. You're standing here before me I'm in your presence right now. And based on my presence, okay, so I'm not talking about my looks or just the words that are coming out of my mouth, okay? Just my presence, P-R-E-S-C-E-N-S-E. I pray that I spelled it correctly. Presence, okay? So I said to him, what do you feel? What are you feeling from talking to me? What's coming from your heart? You know, with talking to me, do you perceive me to think that I'm doing something evil? Does I say that? Or do you perceive something else? Because I don't want you to come up here with what you're sensing to do with me. I want you to come from here. And he said, he said that he felt that I was speaking on something of love, you know, or truth. Because you see, I'm giving you that story because that is where we're heading back to. We're heading back to connecting from our hearts, okay? And that's why it's important that those who judge others, if you don't understand and allow yourself to connect to each human being, to know what the truth is, because the truth is not based on something that you see somebody post, or only based on what the person may be saying, because you may not have the whole entire picture. You may not have the whole entire story, okay? This is about connecting to our hearts. But if you go from up here first and then you start to allow the mind to, you know, send you in circles, or you start thinking all kind of thoughts, and then you start to perceive, and then you start worrying about what somebody else is gonna think, that if you, you know, are aligning with someone else, then guess what? You get caught up in that wheel again. And you say, what wheel? What wheel are you talking about? It's like a karmic energy, a cycle of continuation of doubt, worry, fear, blame, judging. These are the things that have taken place throughout human history for a very, very long time. And the sad thing about it is that, and saying this without judgment, is that when that has happened throughout history, and when I say history, I'm going way back now, okay? I'm going back to Stone Age caveman days, okay? Because there's some people that come across, they're like, my God. I said, that's a caveman. But, you know, I had asked my children, I said, tell me again about the caveman story, okay? Because what has happened to our human history is that when the beast in and of itself, which means it has to do with the aspect and the DNA of human beings, okay? You're made up of atoms, A-T-O-M-S, particles. We're all particles. We're all energy. You're not just this physical body. All these physical things, it's not what's real. I'm saying, yes, Sharon, it's real because I'm seeing it before my very eyes. Well, guess what? You have more eyes besides these two eyes, okay? There's an eyes that connect you. It's a third eye that connects from here to here and to the cosmos, and it's in relation to God, and it is called consciousness, okay? So it's time for you to understand that and how it relates. So I could go on for hours and hours talking, anybody that knows me, but you know, it's like I choose to, being led by spirit, of course, to talk about this where you're seeing me visually, because eventually you will see me even more. Like, if you have questions, ask questions. I love when anyone asks me questions. You know why? Because it pulls out more things out of me, and we're all interrelated and we're interconnected to one another. There is no separation. I'm going to say this again. There is no separation with any of us, okay? We are all connected. When I was shown by God that God is the all of everything, God is the all of everything together, okay? But everything that is with you is going to align for your highest good, not based on someone else's highest good. You see? So the nature of the beast is to kill, to bludgeon, throw someone off a bridge, chop them up, beat them, hurt them, because they don't understand. This is part two. And so labels have been placed on everyone, people, everything, and these labels is what has caused people to be killed, murdered, hurt, locked up. There's all different manners of things that has existed throughout human history, but a lot of people are walking around with masks on. Okay, I'm not talking physical masks. It's a mask. It's a covering up. The soul is of love, and there's no covering up. So we're heading back into an aspect of what I call the naked aspect of your soul. And the way that this has to happen is by going through all of your pain bodies that has been attached to you, as far as your emotional, your astral, your etheric, besides your physical body. Because you see, all these things that you have accumulated is not just in this lifetime. There are things that are occurring in your life that has been through past lives. And so some of you may say, oh, there's no such thing as that. Well, guess what? There is such a thing. And that's why it's important to understand, because that's why people like to label and say that if they're experiencing something negative, that it's the demons, or the demons are out to get me, and all these different what you call a belief system that has occurred, especially in the West Indian culture and most cultures anyway, you know. And right away, and it's like you still get caught up again in another cycle of beliefs and fear, the fear base, the false evidence appearing real. And if you don't allow yourself to understand, and I can, there's so much details that I go into that, but I'm not going to get into all of that right now and what it is that's really happening in that aspect. But I want you to understand that as we start going on later on throughout the rest of this year, there are major things that are going to be happening with more changes, more shifting, purging, experiences. And the more that you resist is the more it persists. As Neil Donald Walsh says, the more you resist, the more it persists. And this is about looking into yourself. Stay in your lane and pay attention to what's happening in your backyard, what's happening within your life. If you start labeling, oh, my child is doing this, or my husband is doing this, or my boss is doing this, or my neighbor is doing this, what is it about you that's reflecting? What is reflecting? So the purpose of what a twin flame is that twin flames are the highest version of mirrors of themselves. And so it started out Andronicus as male and female. And so we separated ourselves and went into two different bodies that have shared the same soul. So you have the masculine and the feminine, okay? And the masculine and feminine can embody a male or a female. So it does not have to be the same gender. Once again, the soul knows no gender. It's not about having a, you know, just a female or a male body, and it is the truth. And in this aspect, we decided to separate ourselves so we can get to have two different experiences and have an understanding as far as that we have our similarities and our differences and our divine complements of one another. Divine complements. Things are shifting and changing where we're coming back to love. Twin flames are here to anchor love on the planet. And it's a vibration that's lifting up the planet. And as the planet is lifting in vibration, when I say lifting in vibration, that means that all that old stuff, all the baggage, everything that has not served humanity is no longer going to be here. The way how Spirit has shown it to me is that everything to all that exists on the other side, when I say the other side, those are of our loved ones that have crossed over to the other side, what has happened is everything to how it is in blissfulness. And I had my own experience of having that whole entire sacred body orgasm. And you say, what's that? That's what I'm saying. So much to understand here. And that is when we're in that state of blissfulness, connecting to God. We get a taste of it as far as true, genuine twin flames. You get to get a feeling of that feeling because that's the original. You know when I say the original style? That is the original style and energy of who we are. Love. The act of making love is a sacred act. It is not about coming from ego and gratification. That is something that has been ordained by God from the beginning of time and is called an alchemical marriage. Our soul is made up of numbers, symbols. We are related to colors, mathematics. Mathematics. That is what this is about. So it's important to talk a lot about that in this book. And how important it is for especially the feminine energies, okay, to come into their power. Because it's for the queens to rise up within themselves. Rising up within yourselves, I'm not talking about a revolution here. I'm talking about taking back your power, your own strength, who you are. Speaking up, speaking your truth. Align with your own truth. Align with your own feelings and thoughts. Your feelings is the strongest language for you. Everything that you say or do is a reflection that comes through from those who are around you. Pay attention to the signs. Pay attention to the synchronicities. Pay attention to everything and take note of it. Live your life to the fullest. Even though you're going through spiritual changes and purging, crying, laughing. Yes, move through it. And you move through it with grace and know that it's not bad, okay? It's not bad. It's a good thing. You know, I've been at that place now where I laugh and cry with my laughter, with laughter of joy and laughter of sadness all at the same time. It's all synchronizing, you see? And know that all of this is a part of coming into your union. It's a part of coming into your union because you're coming into union with your soul, okay? Your soul. Because you see, as I said before, there's always something missing. There's always something that's missing or comes up missing within ourselves. And whatever comes up missing is for us to find that within ourselves. When you find that within yourself, it's going to reflect back to you. And it does not have to necessarily be from a human being. It could be from anything. It could be a plant. It could be a dog, a pet, a cat, a bird. So many different ways that you will feel that. So I want you to know and to understand that when you speak things out, okay, especially when it comes with feelings, you're putting out an energy out there. Wherever you keep your focus on, wherever your focus is on, you are creating your own reality, your own outer world. And I know some people have a hard time understanding that because you think that when you start speaking it out that, which okay, express yourself, okay? Don't forget to come back to yourself though. That's all I'm saying. Complete that circle. Complete the circle. Because if you leave out just one aspect, you're going to keep on saying, well, da 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 da, this one said this, that one said that. And then you just get caught up in that jaka 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 jaka, and it's just chitter chatter, chitter chatter, chitter chatter. And then it goes on and on, and you're on this type of loop instead of coming into this loop. You see, it's a center of completion. You see, zero point, you see. And so that zero point is coming back to a void. This is where you have both polarities are together now. And it's like this instead of like this and, you know, scattered all over. So from what I'm going from my memory, acknowledging yourself, honoring yourself, loving yourself, pampering yourself, being patient with yourself, not judging yourself, love, dance, all of these things play a very important aspect of yourself and to how you can relate to your experiences. See it for what it is from a higher perspective, and then work your way down if you have to. So when you say a higher perspective, that come from a space of love and wisdom first. And say, what is being shown here to me? Your spirit guides, your higher self will lead you to understanding. What numbers are repeating itself? What is it in relation to your twin flame journey from that connects especially to do with your twin, you know, without judging? Not being afraid to speak up. Show yourself. Shine and show yourself. When you show yourself and shine, then guess what? The same thing reflects back to your twin. Okay? And that means that you're not afraid to express yourself. And I'm not saying as far as what you physically say, but also what's in your heart. What is your heart telling you? What is the truth for you from within your heart? And not based on somebody else's experience. Listen to your own experience and ask yourself, what is it saying to me? If I'm having an experience of frustration or anger or pain or whatever, my twin might be experiencing it in a different way. I might be experiencing it in the feminine aspect and he's experiencing it in the masculine aspect, okay? Does it mean that my aspect is better because I'm having more pain than his? No, doesn't mean that. It just is. That's it. It just is. That's the best way that I can put that. We all have our own personalities, our own perceptions, our own understandings. But when we allow ourselves to understand that we all have similarities and differences, then it makes the world a whole lot brighter place. And why I say that is because that's what we're heading back to, honoring each other for our similarities and our differences and not judging it. Not judging it at all. If you like to do a certain thing, you don't want anybody telling you what to do and how you should do it. This is about coming into your own sovereignty, okay? Your own power, your own freedom. You know how many times I say, God, I wish I didn't have to go to the supermarket and go shopping. That's all I'm looking forward to, when we don't have to worry about eating food anymore and we just go to just drinking water and then no water. And all that we're going to be sustaining is the light. The light of the Christ consciousness is what is keeping us anchored with joy. Even as I say it now, my heart is elevating and pumping. You see, we long to know ourselves experientially, okay, through the experience. We long to know ourselves, which we are through each other. And how do we understand ourselves through compassion and love and not judging each other? The world is what it is right now, with anger, hatred, war, crimes, you know, all different things. But guess what? The way for the world to change is to be the change. Be the change. Be what you want the world to be. And yes, of course, take action. Take action. But take this action with love and grace, not with anger and tit for tat and I want to get back at this and labeling and criticizing and judging others. You see? So I do have many, many explanation of things in my segments. It's good to understand our bodies and where we're coming from with healing. And healing, mind, body, and soul. Your soul is grander than you could ever imagine. Grand, I mean, really, truly grand. God's desire is your desire, and your desire is God's will as well. You see? But you have to make a choice. I mean, you don't have to. I mean, to not make a choice is making a choice also. But you make the choice, and your will align with God's will for your highest good. You may not know what your highest good is yet, but trust me, if you ask, you shall receive. The way will be made known to you. When you allow yourself to understand things from a deeper level, deeper. Because even when you have an experience, you might have more than one experience and it might take you high and say, oh my God, you know, and then you might have it again and you end up crying. I said, but why am I going through this again? Then because God wants you to take it deeper. And then you might have it again another few months or a few weeks later. And then God says, she wants you to take it wider. So allow yourself to receive. That's where the feminine energy comes in. Feminine energy does not mean that it's on females. We all carry both polarities. We are both feminine and masculine. Some are in female bodies that carry masculine and feminine. Some might be more feminine, some might be more masculine. There's some masculine males per se who carry more feminine than masculine. It doesn't mean that they're not a man, okay? So this is beyond all of that, and it's for you to understand again. And when we allow ourselves to understand to a greater capacity, then you allow yourself to become receptive and into receiving love. And when you allow yourself to receive love, you give love, you receive love, you give love. It goes in and comes out, and it comes in and it goes out. And then you start living your life in so much greater peace. I even have said the other day, I said, my goodness, I said, you know what? The one thing I treasure more than anything else is peace of mind. I would take peace of mind over any money in the world. You know why? Because when you have peace of mind, you can move forward with such grace and wisdom and love all in one package. That's another aspect of wealth, you see? But if you have the riches and just say, oh, I have the money, I have the money, but then there's parts of you that's like not connecting, then what happens? You start to fall apart. So it's time to pick up the pieces. It's time to pick up the pieces. Like I refer to Humpty Dumpty. You pick up the pieces to your puzzle. And then when you pick up the pieces to your own puzzle, then you'll be able to pick up the pieces to connecting to the other aspect of yourself as the outer puzzle. So, i.e., for example, those who are twin flames. So you have your pieces to your puzzle, and your twin has his or her pieces to his or her puzzle. And they all interconnect and intertwine because we all have something in common. And what I might be lacking, my twin might be able to. And we have the other aspect of when it comes together now, you know, this embodiment. And this embodiment itself is what we are as far as the physical outward expression of God as the mother, father aspect, okay? Divine feminine, divine masculine. And then at some point, it creates a triad, okay? And it has many terms, because I know in the biblical sense they said Father, Son, Holy Spirit, but it's Mother, Father, Holy Spirit. And it combines together into something that creates a third energy. And that third energy is what leads to the Christ consciousness, the head. And when it's anchored in, all the blessings start to come down. All the blessings. So you see, if everyone was to understand what this means for the planet on a grand scale, I'm pretty sure that you will all be working with each other instead of against each other. It makes a difference. Yes, and I was saying before I was cut out. And what's important that I want you to understand is that from whatever is coming up in the next few months, more changes on the planet. That's right. A photon belt. And from what I'm being shown in spirit is that it's like a larger pull, I would say, the best way to describe it. It kind of reminds me of like a tsunami, so to speak. And it's not an actual tsunami, but that is how intense it's going to be. It's like an intensity. And in some ways it may make you feel like you want, like it's, you know, compressing. And you say, well, how do I know what this feels like? Okay, you probably are feeling some of it already. This is where you might have an experience of something. It could be something so simple as somebody says something to you and it triggers you. It could be an experience that you're having directly or indirectly, something you read. You could be reading somebody's posting. You could be reading a book. You could be watching something on TV, and all of a sudden, pay attention to the things that are repeating in your lives. Whatever is being repetitive, because that's where the universe is saying something to you. God is always trying to tell you something, but it's for you to pay attention to the signs. And and you're going to start to become more and more unplugged to what is not real. and things that are not real, you're going to feel it, and it's just not going to ring true for you anymore. And you're like, wait a minute. Oh, that's it. So you might be pulled away from those who are not aligning with you, you know, because we're all on different levels of consciousness. And just because you're on different levels of consciousness does not mean that you're better than the other person. And let me tell you, explain to you why and how that is. God, in of her and himself, that's right, chooses to know itself. I have to say itself because I want you to know that it's the isness of God we're talking about here. The all encompass of God chooses to know itself through each and every one of us. And that includes the good and what you label as the bad. What you may think is bad might be something good coming from it. You just don't know. We do not know what each soul is up to. Okay? And we're connected to one another. We're connected to one another. So anytime there is a separation of something, we're going to feel something. But it's like there's two different and many different aspects to all of this. On the one hand, you love this person. The other hand, you're not getting along with this person. On one hand, you're connected to this one, but you're not to this one. It's okay. Don't feed into every single thing into details, because then you'll drive yourself crazy. Focus on yourself and the relationship you're having with yourself. The relationship you're having with yourself is the key to your happiness and your own joy, okay? And that happiness and joy can be shared with another who may also have their own happiness and joy within themselves. And so it becomes shared. And when I say shared, I'm talking in terms of like-mindedness. And say, hey, guess what happened today? Oh my gosh, I'm feeling the same thing. Oh, I vibrate to this, and oh, I love that. Well, I don't like that too much. That's okay if you don't like it. You don't have to like everything. If we all liked everything and everyone with everything, and we were all waking up at the same time, then I said, you know, the game, the mystery, the suspense, it would be over, okay? So everything is synchronizing. It's going this way, that way, up, this, that, da, 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 da. Some might come back up high like this and come so and this. Do you see what I'm saying? That's why I'm glad I'm making this a visual. So all these things I talk about already, you know, in my book. And while you're going through all these things that may bring you to tears and bring you to sorrow, then you might experience joy again in the morning. In the morning, not necessarily the morning time. Okay, it could be joy coming within you just from what you understand to what you're experiencing. It's about understanding what you're experiencing, okay? And understanding that we are connected to one another. So we eventually, we're all going to see everything through everyone. Clear, crystal clear. And that's the reason why, this is a message for twin flames, why the energy is out there for you to talk about yourself as being a twin flame. There's no need to fear talking about that. There's no need to hide in the corner anymore. Because if you're gonna hide in the corner, then guess what? The other aspect of yourself might hide in the corner too and say, oh, what's this? Oh, I'm crazy. Oh, if I say this, they're going to think I'm crazy. I remember that conversation I had with my twin. He said, you know, you're crazy. I said, no, I'm not. He said, yes, you are. I said, no, I'm not. He said, well, I must be crazy. I said, oh. So it was echoing back to between the both of us. You see, you're not crazy. And even when anybody thinks I'm crazy, I laugh about it, because you know something? As Yeshua, a.k.a. Jesus said, in order for you to enter into this kingdom of heavenliness, you have to be crazy out of your mind, like you are. But I'm not saying that you are. You have to be out of your mind, out of your ego. Because if you're out of your ego, I mean, staying within your ego, excuse me, then how can you understand to receive the gifts? Do you see what I'm saying? And you say, what gifts? The gifts of spirit. It could be anything. Whatever your true heart's desire has been. What is your true heart's desire? Be that which you desire. Be the love of your life. Be the dance of your life. Be the joy of your life. Okay? Bring yourself into that space and center no matter what you're experiencing. You would never know to a full capacity. Even Maya said to me, she said, Shana, she said, you should just walk around with a camera. You know, the camera should just be following you with what life is like with me. In the magical way that it is. And it's because I know my soul is creating this for me. I'm creating all of this because of my own thoughts and consciousness. okay? Me, I'm doing it. I'm thinking the thoughts, and therefore my outer reality is reflecting my inner reality. And those who are in my circle or in my group or whoever contact I make with you, whether it's directly or indirectly, if I've ever met you before, if I've ever come into contact with you, believe me, I know that change is happening for you, because we're all triggering and awakening the changes within ourselves. When you understand that and you allow yourself to understand that, then you will not continue to vibrate towards as much fear. Fear is something that comes from a space of not understanding what it is. And most of the time, the things that we have feared so much turned out to be really nothing to be fearful about in the first place. Because, you know, like my son, he said, Mommy, always everything is always going to work out, and everything is always for a reason. I said, it is for a reason. And he admitted to me and said, yeah, you're right, Mommy. Everything does happen for a reason. Even if it looks bad, it's all for a reason. Follow your own inner guidance. Follow your own inner spirit. Follow your Holy Spirit, because the Holy Spirit is within you. That's your connection to God. That's your divinity to God. This is about connecting back to your center. Okay? Not someone else's center. If you're going through a period of depression and sadness, talk it out. If you can't talk it out to someone, write it down. Express it. Express it outwardly. If you feel the need to want to, pray, meditate, believe me, when you do that, the way will be made known to you. You will be shown the way. But this is where you're seeing things beyond your physical eyes, okay? And then your eyes might be included, you know? The eyes will see the all of everything. Seeing things in not only your eyes, but in each other's eyes. Seeing things from all different perspectives. And when you allow yourself to come from those perspectives, there lies wisdom. So you combine and bring the wisdom with the knowledge and the patience and the understanding, coming from a space of love and compassion for one another. Okay? And adding a little dash of laughter, dancing, move the body. Move the body around, okay? Don't just stay in one space. The soul was not made to stay in one place. The soul was made to move. It moves itself freely. That's the joy in who you are. Don't wait for something to happen in order to be. Don't wait to have this and be that and this first before you become that. Become it now. Stay in that now moment. The present for you is now. Present, P-R-E. -S-E-N-T, the present moment. So pay attention even more than ever before. Pay attention to your signs, your synchronicities. You say, what synchronicities, what signs? It could be anything, numbers, symbols. You probably might be think a thought about something, and then all of a sudden somebody walks by and say, oh, I just saw a purple pony, you know, and all of a sudden you see a purple pony. I'm just giving you an example here. It could be anything. Pay attention to all of that. To all of that. I think about the color purple with Celie when she says, you know, I think God gets mad when we pass by and see the beautiful purple flowers. But God doesn't get mad. That's a human element, okay? It pisses God off, she says, if you pass by the color purple. You see? So in other words, what that means is allow yourself to enjoy everything there is to life. Everything, all the things, the simple things, you know. It could be anything that brings you joy, then do that. Bring yourself to that space. Whether you move to that place of or space of joy, or you bring it to you, okay? You still align with the doing and the being for things to change in your reality. And as you change within your reality, then someone else might see it and feel that vibration, and then it links to each and every one of us. So I talk about in my segments about the 100 monkey theory, you know, where, you know, as one, as you say, little monkey get it, then I'm not saying we're monkeys here, okay? So I'm not gonna get into all that stuff with right, wrong, with whatever we, you know, let's stay with what I'm talking about here. on hand, and it's that we're linked together so much that as we choose to and work with shifting your perception, consciousness working hand in hand with your perception, aligning that with wisdom, okay? And when you align yourself with wisdom, that means that you stop first. When whatever is happening, stop, pause, take a pause. And say, what is God trying to tell me here? What is myself? What am I saying here? What's happening? Take a step back, okay? Analyze it. If you can't figure it out, it's okay. Ask God, your angels, your spirit, God, to show you the way. Show me a sign and you will get it, okay? That's your personal connection to God. When we stay connected to God and allow ourselves to be connected to the divine, to connect to each other, whoever you choose to, it lifts you up. It elevates you, and you will never have to think that you're alone on this path. This is for you to understand there are many ways, many paths to coming back home. Where is home? Where your heart is. A click away. So I just wanted to share this message with you, and I wanted to tell you how much I love each and every one of you, whether I know you or not, whether you like me or not, whether you love me or not, I still love you. I come from a space of unconditional love. Whether you have 2 foot, 2 leg, 2 yard, 5 foot, whatever, I still love you just the way that you are. Okay? We are all reflections of one another. Whatever you see in someone, ask yourself, what do I see in myself? What do I see in myself in that person that I'm interacting with? What is it that you're running away from? No more running, no more hiding. It's time to come out, full front and center. And that means that you're taking back your power. You're not allowing other people to dictate to you how you should live your life, what you should enjoy, who you should be, where you should be, whether you wear your hair short or long, whether you sing, laugh, or dance. You know, whether you wear makeup or not, whatever, where you want to go, where you want to be, who you want to be married to, who you want to stay with, how many kids you want to have, how many you don't want to have, it doesn't matter. Your freedom. I kept seeing horses, a lot of horses, and horses represent freedom. They represent freedom. I think of the butterflies too as freedom. And that freedom starts from within you. You don't need anyone else's permission to have this freedom. And I mean that. I truly mean that. Because once you start to feel that freedom within you and exercise your own power and sovereignty, then anything else other than that just falls off. So I don't worry about anything that, you know, as one would say, is coming my way. I don't, because, you know, of course, you know, as the light continues to shine, the darkness will come, and it's about integrating all of it. You can't get rid of it, because it's an energy. Energy is in motion, okay? So you purge through it, you transmute it, you change it, you shift it. Shift it into another light. Shift it into another aspect, okay? All of this is on purpose. If you run away from it in fear, guess what? It follows you wherever you go, okay? It does. My suggestion is that whatever it is that you fear the most, write them down. Whatever you feel that you're running away from, you might not even be consciously aware of it, because I always suggest to others, videotape yourselves, record yourselves, and listen back to yourself and say, what did I just say there? You see? What did I say there? What I mean? What is coming from my heart? And that will give you a very, very good idea as far as how you are continuing on this path of change. We're all going through changes, and those who choose not to go through the changes, it's already happening anyway. There is no stopping any of this. This is the end times of the beginning times of the end of the beginning. What does that mean? We're coming full circle. Everything comes full circle. We separate, come back together again. The patterns repeat. So work within yourself of healing, forgiveness, patience, wisdom, love, understanding. And don't forget to smile when you can. If you smile more than you frown, and if you stay within laughter more than, you know, the crying, then whenever the other aspect of yourselves that show up, and you say the other aspects of myself, yes, every single person, as I said, that's in your life is an aspect of you that shows up. Whether joy shows up at your door, sadness shows up at your door, whether something you've experienced before and it's here again, and it's okay, it's all right. It's about integrating all of it, you see? It's integrating. That's it. All the elements of ourselves. That's what creates the alchemy. The change, the new version of you. A higher version of me, another version of you, and here's another version and aspect of me. I'm not the same person I was 2 days ago, 2 years ago. Every minute, every second of the day, there's something chemically happening within me. And so no matter what the outer circumstances may appear to be, no one can take away this joy that's within me. And I will continue to be this expression of love because I'm here for love. I'm the instigator of love. I'm the epitome of love, passion, wisdom, strength. And I stay within that energy of unconditional love. So I will end on this note. Don't forget to dance as I'm playing the dub style of Bob Marley. Long time we don't have a nice time, and I sang it to my grandson. Long, 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 long time we don't have no nice time. Do you, yeah, think about that. Long time we don't have no nice time. Do you, yeah, think about that. Long time we don't have no nice time. Do you, yeah, think about that. This is my song. Think about that. Long, 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 long time we don't have no nice time. Do you remember? Think about that. This is my song to rock you there. I give you love, the time they'll care. This little heart in me just won't let it be. I want to rock with you. Won't you rock with me? A long, 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 long time we don't have no nice time. Do you, yeah, think about that. Long, 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 long time. So just move the body and rock the body and shift things. It's not, you're not to stay one place, okay? If you go one way, don't forget to come back the other way and create that inner balance that reflects your outer balance. I love you. Namaste.